Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to make a very quick, easy and very adaptable snack using bread. The name of the snack is bread besan toast. So you don't need to actually serve this as a snack only. You can use it as a breakfast option also when you're in a hurry. And this requires very few ingredients which are always available at home, hence making it very adaptable. So let's start with the ingredients. Of course, you need bread, butter, coriander leaves, capsicum, onion, ginger, green chilies. I've chopped all of these finely. I've got some grated beetroot and carrot in this bowl. This is the vegetable I'm using today. You can use any vegetable of your choice according to what is available at home. It can be cabbage, cauliflower, beetroot, carrot, corn, anything of your choice. Even spinach can be used. Then we need gram flour or besan, water, chat masala. This is totally optional. If you don't have it at home, it's okay. You can just use a squeeze of lime instead of the chat masala, and salt to taste. So let's start with the dish. So I've already grated the beetroot and carrot. I've grated it using the finest grater that is available. It's really fine. Into this bowl, we'll add the rest of the veggies and the gram flour. Pour some water and we'll make a batter out of it. So let's start. I've added all the vegetables and the onion, ginger, green chilies, coriander, capsicum, everything into this bowl. I'm just giving it a nice mix. Make sure you chop it really fine because we have to put this on the bread. So if it's very big pieces, it's not going to stay. So once this is mixed, we add in the chaat masala and the salt. Be careful with the salt. The chaat masala already has a little bit of salt in it. So just be careful when you add salt to it. Okay, so now I've got the chaat masala and the salt also inside the mixture. In case you're not having a chaat masala at home, just squeeze a half a wedge of a lime into this instead of the chaat masala. Now I'm going to add gram flour. You need around 4 to 5 tablespoons. Just check how much you require and then add accordingly. So I've mixed it up well now. Now we're going to add a little bit of water. And we have to make this into a cheese spread like consistency. Shouldn't be too thick or loose. So pour little by little. Since I've added beetroot, the color is coming as red now. But if you omit beetroot, it's going to be yellow in color. I'm adding beetroot just for the color factor. It looks really different when you put in this color. I think a lot of people don't like beetroot, but it's a very good vegetable which has a lot of iron in it. So it's really good for kids. I think I can add a little more water. Just be careful. I think this should be fine. Okay, so we'll just start spreading it on the bread slices. And if it's too thick, then we'll add a little water then. Take a bread and on the slice, just spread this mixture that we have made. Be a little generous with the mixture. that's slice one. And we are going to do the same thing with the rest of the slices. I've got a pan heating here and I put butter over it. Now you take a slice of bread, this bread side onto the pan. I would suggest you use a non-stick pan because besan can really stick onto the pan. So make sure you use a non-stick pan. Now you're going to put this in and toast it until golden brown on both sides and until the besan is cooked. It's been some time, so I'm going to just flip the toast. Looks like it's cooked on the other side. So now we'll just make the bottom golden brown. The toast have been done on both ends. See, the besan is cooked and the bottom side has also got color. So this is ready. For serving, I'm going to slice this into triangles. And these can be served with tomato ketchup. So if you are not adding beetroot to this dish, the besan portion will look yellow once it's done. So do try this recipe at home and let me know how you found it. I'm sure your kids will love them. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.